Go.
You guys play instruments, right?
Yeah.
What instrument do you play, Kwame?
The guitar, the drums, play bass, play a keyboard.
Nice. Yeah. And you learned this like on your own or you?
Yeah, on my own because I've been with the instruments since I was a kid. So. Yeah, I learned all my own. Yeah.
And you play?
Yeah, I play the keyboard and guitar.
Nice. How does that enhance your music, though? I mean, coming from someone who just plays it.
It does. Because before I started learning beat making, I used to play on the keyboard. Right. I could write a beautiful song with just the piano. I don't know how to produce.
Okay.
When I go into the studio, the producer will listen to what I've done. I mean, I could imagine if I didn't know how to play the piano. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to start everything from scratch for the producer. And sometimes piano gives you melodies. If you play an instrument,
yeah,
gives you melodies to write rich, soulful music.
Right.
Even no matter how the beat sounds, as far as you use an instrument to write the songs,
yeah,
there's always that element
that inspires
of soul,
you. Yeah.
I think and I think learning to play the instrument when I was young helped in me learning to produce that quick. Because I started producing when I was just 17, 18. Because I could play everything.
Okay, so hang on a second. So by producing, you mean you were actually the one who was putting the beats together?
Yeah.
Wow. So you're a producer as well?
Yeah. He is too.
Whoa, guys, this is something
this is amazing,
serious.
Yeah?
Yeah, this is something serious. Because a lot of people just, like, would go into a studio, get a beat from someone, and hopefully it works. They put some lyrics on it. Do you write your own songs?
Yeah.
So both these songs were written by you?
Yeah.
Oh, tell me about your aspirations. I mean, tell me where you want to go, guys, because this has started on a really good note.
Yeah.
You know?
Really good note.
Yes. Literally, you know? Talk to me. What are your dreams?
I think where we want to go, it can't actually be told because maybe it does not exist.
Maybe we'll limit ourselves by anything we want to go.
Yeah, because
yeah,
the reason why we are putting in more work, and me in particular, I want to get to somewhere no African has been before. Because
yeah?
I mean, on my side, I'm saying I should be someone every African looks up to. Like, I want to be like a Kwame Eugene in the next 10 to 15 years. Yeah.
Great. Kitty, tell me about your dreams.
Me, I always say that, Charlie, I've given myself a time frame that within some time, I want to be a household name in Ghana and Africa.
Oh, you're working on it.
When you mention Kitty, people get excited.
Mm.
If you have an album coming up and Kitty doesn't have a verse on the album,
it's not going to happen. It ain't happening.
If you have a show and Kitty's not on the bill, we won't buy tickets because they want to see the Ghana and Sugar rock this thing.
All right. Let's talk about groupies and fans, you know, because from what I hear, Charlie, when you guys go anywhere, and even some hotel or something, you see the girls just, is it actually true? Are those rumors true? No, I'm serious. Is it true?
Oh, it's true on his side, though.
On our side, though.
So who's lying, man? I'm sure both of you get that kind of attention.
I mean, the thing is, you see, human beings are attracted to success. It's a natural thing. You can't fault them. Once something is going right in your life, people want to be associated with you. Girls are coming. Like, they like our music. Some of them like us. Some of them like what we do. So, I mean,
some just want to be friends.
Yeah, some just want to be friends.
But are you guys dating? Like, are you
yeah, absolutely. No.
Hey. So this is live on TV.
Yeah,
so.
No. I'm not dating.
Yeah,
I don't single. Know for Kitty though, but
single, ready to mingle.
Single? I don't know about ready to mingle.
Well,
I mean, we're just chilling.
Hey.
All right, here we go.
Anywhere you dare, I go there. My sherry cocoa, my wine and money. Any car you want, I go ask you. Baby, take my heart, baby, carry go. If you think I go need you, God forbid. God forbid. If you leave me now, that'd be easy. You will show me things I can't resist, yeah. I go mention your name to the whole wide world. If you will give me joy, Jessica. Jessica, give me the best quality of life, and joy.
So you go back. It's a great way to end this show. You know, this is the very last episode, but I promise to come your way again. Before we go, though, guys, we need to take that selfie. That selfie
that
I can show off to my friends and say, "Yeah, I was hanging out with." For those of you who have been following the conversations, I'm sure you've been inspired. Better Malls is all about going all the way up, pursuing your dreams, and never actually stopping. And so, just keep the fire burning, keep it alive, keep the inspiration, going, and I'm sure that you will achieve those goals by the time you're done. Plus, remember, you can find us on Facebook and on Instagram, BetterMallGH. There are some exciting things going on our page, so lots of surprises. You know, just follow us, and you'll be entertained throughout. All right. So my name is Jessica. Of course, been here with Kwame, Eugene, and Kitty. And it's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. We're heading out to the studio.
You would have shown me things I can't resist, yeah. I go mention your name to the whole wide world, but see, be you the Angela. Angela, you be the best quality of wifey, Angela.